Hi, for those of you who don't know who I am, my name is Johnny O, and I host a radio show in Chicago called the Johnny O Gospel Show. And recently, I did an interview with Lawrence Coldon, the father of Fingers Coldon, about his daughter that has been missing since December the 18th. And right now, I want to share that interview with you.
Welcome to the Johnny O Gospel Show. Last week, I started an interview with Lawrence Coldon, the father of the missing young lady named Phoenix Coldon. And for time's sake, I had to do the interview off air. But this morning, I'm going to bring to you the conclusion of the interview. But before I do, in just a second, I'm going to refresh your memory by playing some of the first interview I did with him.
And my wife came home from church that Sunday, December 18th, and everything seemed to be okay at the time. And Phoenix, it was a rather warm day here in St. Louis, and she was outside in the back of the home. We have a basketball goal out there, and she was out there shooting some basketballs. And she came in the house, and she left out and went and got in her SUV, and she was just sitting there.
Mm-hmm.
So we figured she was on the phone or something like that, how young people do at times. And I saw her back out of the driveway. I said, oh, she must be going to the store. And we never saw her. We haven't seen her since then.
I see.
And it was just puzzling and strange because she always had enough respect for us to phone us or to tell us where she would be, and she never stayed away from home overnight.
I see.
And living here with us, she never would do anything like that. So when she didn't come home, 11:30, 12 o'clock, my wife was very worried.
Mm-hmm.
And I knew that at that point, there was nothing we could do except go look for her ourselves or call our friends and ask them where she might be, because the police won't do anything at that point. And we called the police the next day after 24 hours, and the officer that came out confirmed what I already knew. He lectured us about her age,
mm-hmm.
what she could do if she wanted to, and that he couldn't file a report.
I see.
But he did check, run her tags to see if she had been in an accident, if the car had been towed or anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
And he suggested that we start calling the hospitals and so forth.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what we did. That next day, matter of fact, that night, we started calling the hospitals and on through to the next day and continuing to talk to friends and family to see if they knew anything. And no one had heard from her, had seen her. We knew something was definitely wrong at the time.
I see.
But what we didn't know was that same day, December 18th, at 2:26 p.m., I believe it was. I'm sorry, 5:26 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
Phoenix left home about 3 p.m. At 5:26 p.m., that car was towed from a location in East St. Louis, Illinois. It's approximately 23 miles from where we live.
Mm-hmm.
Is where that car was found abandoned. Her black 1998 SUV was found abandoned in East St. Louis at 9th and St. Clair Avenue. It was the tow yard said it was towed at 5:26 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
The thing that cost us so much time and maybe evidence was that the officer who had the vehicle towed did not call the county where the vehicle was registered to let the officers in that county know that a car had been abandoned in their area. And if he had done that, then these officers would have let us know, called us or came out and said, do you know where your vehicle is?
I see.
But it was January 1st. Now, she left home December 18th. January 1st, through a family friend, we found that vehicle. It was in a tow yard in East St. Louis, had been there for 2 weeks, and no one had notified us that it was there.
I see.
Phoenix was a lovely young, she is a, I'm sorry, I shouldn't have said was, she is a lovely young lady.
That's right.
Very intelligent, beautiful young lady. She was a fencer, a champion fencer. She was a pianist.
And now, here is the conclusion of that interview.
The last time we spoke, Mr. Lawrence, you gave the listening audience to know what transpired with Phoenix disappearing. And today, I wanted to know, have you heard any new information about Phoenix since she disappeared?
Well, we had sightings of Phoenix.
Mm-hmm.
People were saying that they were seeing Phoenix in different locations around the metropolitan area in East St. Louis and St. Louis. And when we would check these sightings out, we would find out that if people were not actually seeing our daughter.
I see.
And several times, one time actually, the St. Louis County Police came to our home with a photograph of a young lady on a metro bus where a lady had identified her as being our daughter, Phoenix. And when they brought the photograph to us, even the detectives felt it was her, but it wasn't.
I see.
Yeah, so people were thinking they were seeing Phoenix, but they weren't.
I see.
And we had sightings in East St. Louis, Illinois, and in St. Louis, Missouri. And one time, we even had someone in Texas that was actually saying that we felt that he had our daughter, but that proved not to be true also.
I see.
It was a hoax, yes.
So is Phoenix your only child, or do you have more children?
No, Phoenix is our only child. My wife and I, she's our only child. Now, I have a son by a previous marriage, but Phoenix is Goldie and I's only child.
So how has you and your wife been dealing with the situation? I mean, have you all been getting emotional support from friends and family, or has kind of been like a situation where they don't understand?
Well, a lot of them don't understand. And at times, friends will say, well, I didn't want to call because I didn't know what to say.
Mm-hmm.
And also they will say that, well, we thought you guys were getting a lot of calls, so we didn't call. And family is a totally different thing. Family seems to have their own opinion of what we should and shouldn't do.
I see.
And of us personally. So when you talk about family, it's completely different. You have to defend yourself against family at times because they have their opinions of what we should have done, what we didn't do, what we could have done, what was right and what was wrong.
Right.
And if we raised our child in the correct way.
So, Mr. Lawrence, in what ways can the saints of God help you in finding your daughter?
Consistent and a constant basis.
That's right.
Okay.
Okay.
And that website is o4lm.com.
Okay. Can you repeat that again, Mr. Lawrence?
Okay, it's the letter o4lm.com.
Okay. Okay, so Mr. Lawrence, I would like to thank you for taking time out to be on the show and to share the story about Phoenix, because it's a story that I am believing is going to have a positive outcome.
Thank you.
When God's people pray and take the pains of earth to the dark.
That was the story of Phoenix Coldon. And like I said, I believe that it's going to have a positive outcome. And one way that we can kind of make sure that it does is by praying for her. It's the least we can do, because what if that was our child or our relative? We would want someone to pray for us and uplift us up in prayer. So I encourage you to do that, and if you're able to help this family financially in their efforts to look for their daughter, help out, because their home is in foreclosure and they went broke trying to locate their daughter. And in the article it said that they would do it again, and I would do it as well if I was in their shoes. Because you can replace things, but you can't replace a person's life. And with that being said, I want to say that I love you, and I will talk to you on Wednesday.
When God's people pray and take the pains of earth to the doors of heaven.